grew up in Western Pennsylvania, and where I grew up was out in the country. When you would leave my backyard, you would go out through a field and down a hill, and eventually you'd come to a stream of water. In Western Pennsylvania, we call that stream of water a creek. Whenever I was 10 or 12 years old, I used to play down in the woods along that stream of water. I had a spot, and that spot was my favorite spot as a kid to play. There were these two huge rocks that were along the side of the water. Off in the woods, in this quiet space, and I used to go down there and would sit on top of the rocks and play on the rocks and pretend I was king on the hill and all that kind of stuff, or sit there and throw pebbles in the water and just really enjoyed being in my spot. Whenever I was in my early 40s, I was back visiting and I went for a walk down through those woods to see my spot again. And I got there and I was shocked. It was like it wasn't my spot anymore. Those two big rocks weren't on the side of the stream anymore. They now were flipped over in the middle of the stream. And I looked at that and I thought, who could have done that? And then I realized, nature probably did that. Probably with the seasonal flooding that happens in the spring as the snow melts, the water would rise, those rocks got jostled around and moved into the water. And so that changed my spot. Yeah, my spot had changed. It wasn't the way I remembered it. Everything changes. Even those big rocks that I thought were permanent changed. They moved. You know, I changed too. Whenever I was a kid, 10, 12 years old, I would leave my parents' home and I would run the quarter to a half mile down to my spot to go play. In my 40s, well, that was a walk and sort of a careful walk going through the woods, making sure I stayed on the path. And now in my 60s, if I would take that same walk, well, you better be sure that I'd have my walking stick to make sure that I had sure footing going on that way. I've changed. I'm not that 10, 12-year-old anymore. I'm now in my 60s, and how I approach life is different. So things around us change, and we change. And that's the nature of life. Everything changes. Nothing stays the same. Hopefully for ourselves, as we change, we grow and evolve. And hopefully the world becomes a better place. But that's really a hope. That isn't a guarantee. One of the things that happens with this natural change is that we don't notice it. We're going with the flow and we're not quite aware of it until something makes us aware. I became aware whenever I saw those rocks moved into a different place. Then I knew that place had changed. But when things fall apart in our life, the change is sudden. We know immediately that something is wrong and that something has changed, and we have a lot of emotions about it. We're frustrated, we're angry, we're sad, we experience loss. It's change in a heightened place. You know, the Buddhists talk a lot about change. In Buddhism, impermanence is an important principle. Impermanence really just means that everything's always changing. The world is changing, we're changing. And to be aware, to be mindful of impermanence means that we step back in a way that we're not so attached to the way things are right now, but recognize that it's all changing and it will always be changing. And so we need to really just sort of go with the flow. When things fall apart, it doesn't help someone to hear, well, things are always changing, but it does help us in advance. The more we're able to adapt to the perspective that things are always changing, that nothing will stay the same, the easier time we have when real difficulties happen in life and life falls apart. because we're able to recognize that this is only a moment. And other moments down the road are going to be different from this moment. The same is true for our emotions. Our emotions may be intense in one time because of one experience, like when things fall apart, but our emotions don't last forever. They also change. There are days when we feel happy and sunny, and there are days when we feel sad and blue. That's part of an emotion, and emotions don't last forever. They ebb and flow and change and evolve, just like everything else. So I think it's important for us to recognize when things fall apart that having this awareness of impermanence, that things are always changing, will help us through that process. But it also helps us through life in general to be aware of life as an ongoing transition. Because that's indeed what it is. It's always moving. It's always moving in a new direction. In the next two videos, I'm going to talk more about different aspects of life falling apart. I want you to be sure to catch those videos. So subscribe to this channel, click the bell so that you're notified of those videos. And of course, leave me some comments about how you experience life is changing in the role of impermanence, and as always, like this video. Thanks for taking some time with me today. I appreciate your reflecting with me on life always changing in impermanence. It's an important perspective for us to have for every day of our life. Have a great day.